Hello to all my friends in the Brotherhood of Locomotive Engineers and Trainmen. I sure wish I could join you in person for your convention in Las Vegas. There's nobody I would rather be with than my labor friends, but we're going to have to settle for a video this time. So I want to start by thanking Jim Hoffa, Ken Hall, and Dennis Pierce for the invitation to speak today. While we're in Washington trying to fight to make things better for working families, it helps to know that smart, tough labor leaders like Jim and Ken and Dennis have my back. I really appreciate it. And while I'm giving shout outs, I need to give a couple of warm salutes to my Massachusetts guys, John Murphy and John Tolman. Way to go, guys. And while I'm here today, I just want to speak a little bit about the fights we're facing here in Washington. I'm not going to sugarcoat this. We're really up against it with the Trump administration. You know, I get it. Donald Trump made a lot of campaign promises to look out for the interests of working families. But nearly every appointment he's made and every policy he's pursued since this election undercuts the interests of working men and women. Trump brought in a slew of Wall Street bankers, of industry insiders, of special interest lobbyists right into his cabinet. And he's done their bidding every step of the way during his first year and a half in office. The sad reality is that Donald Trump hasn't kept any of the promises he made during the 2016 election about helping working people. In fact, he's done exactly the opposite, hurting middle-class workers all across this country, people who just want a fair shot to support their families. The frustration of these families is real. And it's justified. Working families are deeply frustrated about an economy and a government that only works great for the rich and the powerful, and that leaves everyone else in the dirt. People are angry that wages have been stagnant for a generation, while basic costs like housing and healthcare and childcare have skyrocketed. Angry that our political system is awash in dark money and barely legalized campaign bribery. Angry that Washington is willing to give away a fortune in tax breaks for billionaires and CEOs while it refuses to raise the minimum wage or even help the millions of Americans struggling with student loans or enforce the law when the millionaires who fund our political campaigns break it. Angry that Washington pushes big corporate interests in trade deals, but won't make the investments in infrastructure to create good jobs right here in America. Angry that Washington tilts the playing field for giant corporations, giving them special privileges, letting them amass enormous economic and political power. Angry that Washington dithers and spins and does the backstroke in an ocean of money, while the American dream moves further and further out of reach for too many families. Angry that working families are in debt, angry that seniors can't stretch a Social Security check to cover the basics. And Donald Trump's solution to these problems? His solution is to point fingers at people who don't look like him, who don't talk like him, who don't worship like him. They want us pointing fingers at each other so we won't notice who's making off with all the money. Let's face it, the playing field is tilted against hardworking families, and we need to fight back against the powerful interests that keep the game rigged against our families. And that's why now, more than ever, the United States needs a strong labor movement. I'm in Washington, fighting for our families. You can count on me, and I'm counting on you. Shoulder to shoulder, that's how we're going to improve the lives of working people everywhere, to give all our families a fighting chance. So, thanks for everything you do. We're going to be in this fight together.